click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, welcome back to the subject of Machine Design 1. We are right now learning about design of various springs, basically helical springs. In the last session, we have seen the design aspects of fluctuating loads or design aspects of the spring when it undergoes the fluctuating loads. In today's session, we are going to look at a simple numerical where only fluctuating loads are considered and how factor of safety will be generated. So let us quickly look at it. So the problem statement is there in front of you, which says that conclude factor of safety for following design. So in short, we need to find out factor of safety. Helical compression spring used for can is given, that's the application mentioned. Preload given is 50 newton, so it is already loaded by 50 newton amount of load. Maximum load is 150 newton. So students, here we need to understand that this is the minimum load that is acting on the given spring and this is the maximum load acting on the spring. Ahead, they have mentioned the diameter of wire, which is 3 mm, and the nominal diameter of the spring coil. Next, they have given us the material for oil hardened. So it is the oil hardened tempered material, whose ultimate strength is mentioned 1430 newton per millimeter square. So with this data, let us move ahead and find out the required factor of safety, because here, or whenever the factor of safety is mentioned in the problem of springs with all such loadings, it is a problem of fluctuating loads. So let's start with some of the factors which are very well known to us. This is the spring index, and we know that it is given by this particular relation. After substituting the given values, we get that spring index is equal to 6. The next factor is Wall's correction factor, and that is given by this particular equation. After substituting the values, we get the value somewhere comes out to be 1.2525. Let's move ahead with finding the next factor, Ks. We know that the relation is given and it says that this is the formula. The value comes out to be, the next thing is the mean value of P. We know that it is given by P max plus P minimum divided by 2. The thing upon using, the value is 50 and 150. The value comes out to be 100 newton. The second thing is the amplitude load. Now we know that it is given by P max minus P minimum divided by 2. The value comes out to be 50 newton. So these are the important factors that we are going to use in the subsequent steps. Now the next target is to find out the stresses. We know that this is the mean shear stress and this is the amplitude torsional stress. So using this factor, after solving, we'll get the value somewhere equal to 183.91 newton per millimeter square. The next thing is torsional amplitude stress. Using the given value, Wall's factor is 1.2525. The amplitude force value. And after solving this, we will get the value somewhere equal to 1.2525. The next step is to find out the relation between them based on the given material. Now we have been given oil hardened and tempered material, where the relation of the yield stress and the endurance value of this race are different. Using these relations, let's find out the values. The value comes out to be, similarly, having known these values, the next important thing is to put them into the relation, empirical relation. You can of course find this relation, let me repeat this, in PhD data book, where you need not by heart this particular relation. Now, using this relation, let us move ahead. The value of amplitude torsional stress divided by the yield stress divided by unknown, which is FOS, minus the mean value is equal to . So after solving this expression, the only unknown that we have is factor of safety, comes out to be somewhere around 1.26. In short, for the given conditions, considering the material properties, we come across that after using these values, as far as the safety is concerned, the safety will be at least 1.26 times the allowable values. So in this case, if factor of safety is not a big constraint, our design is going to be anyhow safe. So there we conclude with this numerical, where under the action of fluctuating loads, we have found out the factor of safety. In such numerical, we are supposed to find out factor of safety most prominently unless and until any other aspect is asked. So there we end with this. In the next session, we are going to solve a numerical in which not only the static but also variable or fluctuating loads are going to act. And there we will demonstrate how to select a material, different properties, and how to find out the factor of safety considering both static as well as the fluctuating loads. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to Ikeda. Thank you.